Hello again. Okay, I'm gonna show you this time around is a non-spicy vermicelli noodle. Okay, how I do it, the way I do it. Okay, there's this time around I just decided not to go for something that's spicy, but you can add chili if you want to, which I will add at the end of it. But part of the cooking, I will not add chili to it. All right, it's called white vermicelli noodle, fried noodle. Yeah, I can't recall what's the name really, but for what I can understand is it's always they call it birthday noodle. All right, me birthday, so it's always made during birthday. I reckon the reason why is that it's not spicy, so during birthday people comes and and enjoy the food from different background, and they try not to make it spicy so that everyone can enjoy it. If you want it to be spicy, just there is a side pickled chili for you to add on, or some fresh chili to add on. So there you go, me birthday. There you go. There you have it, the sequence of how I'm gonna prepare it. Okay, not to forget, I'm gonna start off with oil. I'm gonna put the onions. Then I'm gonna put the garlic. I'm gonna put prawn, which is deveined, fish cake, beef. Then I put the veggies. Okay, how I arrange the veggies, the stem is at the top and the leaves is at the base. So that I just use the top bit first, followed by the base. Vermicelli noodles, which I've soaked in cool water for about 10-15 minutes. So what I've done here is I just use the scissors and cut it so that it's easier to work around it after. Okay, this is okay. I boiled the beef earlier and I used the broth, and also what I've added here is a chicken stock. All right, so I'm gonna use this sparingly. If it gets too dry, I will use this to make it a bit moist. Okay, all right, white pepper, salt, light soy sauce. Okay, I'm gonna put in a bit of the coriander, and the chili and the coriander will be used at the end of it as a garnish, and also the sliced omelette. Okay, basically it's just pan fried omelette which I've rolled and I just slice it thinly, basically just to put at the top of it to add flavor and garnishing. Okay, the hot is already the wok is already hot, so I'm gonna put in the rest of the ingredient inside. Here comes. I thought it's hot, but it's not. Never mind, just let it pick up its heat. I'm gonna put the onion first, okay? Only because if I gotta put them together, the chances of the garlic being burnt is pretty high. Okay, let it fry first. I'm gonna get the rest of the ingredient, the prawn and the fish cake and the beef. I'm just gonna put it at the side, then we go along. Right now the heat has picked up. Okay, a bit more. Okay, I'm gonna stop for a moment. Okay, after a couple of minutes or so. All right, next we're gonna add in the garlic, fry a bit more. Okay, by now the onion is a bit translucent. It'll be just bang, 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 right? Once it's ready, just keep going. We got all the things ready at the side. That's one thing about stir frying is got everything ready. Easy to make on a lazy day meal. Garlic is ready. Onion. No, no, the onion. This doesn't look like onion. The prawn. Few seconds later, put in the fish cake. I like it to cut a bit bigger, only because it gives a bit of bite. If it's too small, it just get mixed with the rest of the ingredient. You wouldn't know what you're beating. And the boil. Beef. Okay, you can use any other meat. You can use chicken, you can use lamb, whatever meat you want to use. But yep, for today I'm gonna use beef. Plonk everything in there. Okay, it's easy, isn't it? Just add everything in there. Probably that's the reason why it's really popular during birthday, especially during kids' birthday. Okay, it's like a common thing. Kids' birthday, you will see this kind of noodle. Okay, now I've got the stock ready. A bit of stock. Okay, we normally I just put bit by bit. We'll see how it goes. Because once the noodle goes in, what we don't want to happen is for the noodle to get too soggy. All right, I'm ready to add the noodle in. Yep, toss everything in there, just keep stirring. Okay, it's okay if the prawn is not fully cooked yet, because it'll be cooked anyway during the process of turning the noodles. See, I'm not gonna put the veggie now because it gets overcooked and soggy. All right, so the meat in, and life is good. Okay, I can put some of the soy sauce inside. Okay, normally what I'll do is I cook a bit, I put a bit, I taste. Cook a bit, I taste. So that way, if it's over or under seasoned, I'll know. Two teaspoons of salt to start with. Pepper. Alright, be generous with pepper. Okay. Okay, I have to say, in regards to the vermicelli noodle, it all depends on the... I prepare it according to the manufacturer's recommendation. I'll read at the back of it. Okay, some of it say, put in warm water. Some of them say, cool water. Okay. But if I'm going to cook it, normally I will just put it in the cool water. Okay, unless if it's like on the side, where I'm just going to add soup to it and just eat it straight away, then I put warm water. It's a bit of a... bit of a work, isn't it? Just using one hand stirring the noodles and the other hand holding the camera. Okay, and also in the videos I try not to include the part where I cut the, you know, I chop the onions or the ingredients, all this stuff, I believe you all know how to do it. It's pretty easy to do it. It just takes too much time. You're gonna be bored looking at me doing all this stuff. I like it. Something is ready. And just get on with business. Know what I mean? Okay, it's a bit wet. That's fine. I think the rest of it will be absorbed by the little excess moisture. You're almost ready. If you look at the prawns, it's cooked to perfection already. Okay, I'm gonna get the scissors just to make it easier, and also be careful not to cut the prawn. Gotta get half prawn. It's okay to cut the meat. As I lift, I cut. As I lift, I cut. Almost ready. Time for the veggies. Okay. Fast, isn't it? You can time it, you can get it done in 15 minutes and using one hand. And the wok will be moving around. Lucky there's a splash bag that will hold things in place. Toss in some coriander leaves. Okay, the noodle is pretty much ready. Okay, this is it. Okay, easy stir fry noodles. All right, oops, the rest of the veg. Pop it in. Yep. 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 Okay, dogs. Okay, don't forget to taste it, okay? I'm gonna put another half teaspoon of salt. Okay, what I did, I go grab a fork to taste it. Let's try, see if there's enough seasoning inside. Okay. Enough salt. Noodles a bit dry. Let it cook a bit more. And it'll be ready. So there you have it, alright. Nothing much to add on. Probably I just add a bit of pepper because I like to be it a bit on the spicy side. Not overly spicy. Bit of heat. Okay, it's done. Alright, after this I'm gonna plate it and I'm gonna show it to you. Okie dokes. Okay, it's all done. Yep. 15 minutes done and dusted, fast and furious. All right, I'm plating as well. Okay, all right, let me show it to you from all angles. Ding 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 ding. There you go, birthday noodle. Cheers.